The Pitfalls of Loneliness. Loneliness is a universal human emotion that is both complex and unique to each individual. Because it has no single common cause, the prevention and treatment of this potentially damaging state of mind can vary dramatically. For example, a lonely child who struggles to make friends at school has different needs than a lonely older adult whose spouse has recently died. Definition of loneliness. While common definitions of loneliness describe it as a state of solitude or being alone, loneliness is actually a state of mind. People who are lonely often crave human contact, but their state of mind makes it more difficult to form connections with other people. Loneliness, according to many experts, is not necessarily about being alone. Instead, if you feel alone and isolated, then that is how loneliness plays into your state of mind. For example, a college freshman might feel lonely despite being surrounded by roommates and other peers. A soldier beginning their military career might feel lonely after being deployed to a foreign country, despite being constantly surrounded by other troop members. Loneliness versus solitude. While research clearly shows that loneliness and isolation are bad for both mental and physical health, being alone is not the same as being lonely. In fact, solitude actually has a number of important mental health benefits, including allowing people to better focus and recharge. Loneliness is marked by feelings of isolation despite wanting social connections. It is often perceived as an involuntary separation, rejection, or abandonment by other people. Solitude, on the other hand, is voluntary. People who enjoy spending time by themselves continue to maintain positive social relationships that they can return to when they crave connection. They still spend time with others, but these interactions are balanced with periods of time alone. Causes of loneliness. Contributing factors to loneliness include situational variables, such as physical isolation, moving to a new location, and divorce. To the death of someone significant in a person's life can also lead to feelings of loneliness. Additionally, it can be a symptom of a psychological disorder such as depression. Depression often causes people to withdraw socially, which can lead to isolation. Loneliness can also be attributed to internal factors such as low self-esteem. People who lack confidence in themselves often believe that they are unworthy of the attention or regard of other people, which can lead to isolation and chronic loneliness. Health risks associated with loneliness. Alcohol and drug misuse. Altered brain function. Antisocial behavior. Decreased memory and learning. Depression and suicide. Increased stress levels. Poor decision making. The rise of the internet and, ironically, social media are partially to blame. Experts believe that it is not the quantity of social interaction that combats loneliness, but the quality. Having a few close friends is enough to ward off loneliness and reduce the negative health consequences associated with this state of mind. Tips to prevent and overcome loneliness. Loneliness can be overcome. In the long run, making a change can make you happier, healthier, and enable you to impact others around you in a positive way. Here are some ways to prevent loneliness. Consider community service or another activity that you enjoy. These situations present great opportunities to meet people and cultivate new friendships and social interactions. Expect the best. Lonely people often expect rejection, so instead, try focusing on positive thoughts and attitudes in your social relationships. Focus on developing quality relationships. Seek people who share similar attitudes, interests, and values with you. Recognize that loneliness is a sign that something needs to change. Don't expect things to change overnight, but you can start taking steps that will help relieve your feelings of loneliness and build connections that support your well-being. Understand the effects of loneliness on your life. There are physical and mental repercussions to loneliness. If you recognize some of these symptoms affecting how you feel, make a conscious effort to combat them. Join a group or start your own. For example, you might try creating a meetup group where people from your area with similar interests can get together. You might also consider taking a class at a community college, joining a book club, or taking an exercise class. Strengthen a current relationship. Building new connections is important, but improving your existing relationships can also be a great way to combat loneliness. Try calling a friend or family member you have spoken to in a while. Talk to someone you can trust. Reaching out to someone in your life to talk about what you are feeling is important. This can be someone you know, such as a family member, but you might also consider talking to your doctor or a therapist. If loneliness is affecting your well-being, there are things that you can do that can help you form new connections and find the social support that you need. Whatever you choose to do, just remember that there are people who can help.